Hello, learners. How are you? Hope you are doing well in your studies. With the exams approaching soon, Unacademy is back with revision batches and Revise-a-thon 2.0, and it is even bigger than before. Revise-a-thon 2.0 is a 5-day event for learners of class 9 to 12 to revisit all important topics and get set for their final and board exams. The top educators from Unacademy are already preparing themselves to help you revisit all important concepts in 5 power-packed sessions for each subject from 16th of January to 20th of January. So get ready to attend this absolutely free event, which is open for all. Also, you can enroll for the dedicated revision batches for your class and for the subjects as per your choice. Top educators from Unacademy will teach you and will solve your doubts. Sounds interesting? All you need to do is visit the landing page to enroll. More details and a link for enrollment is given in the description box. To enroll, you can also download the Unacademy app from the Play Store. Then, enter your mobile number for sign up. Fill all the details such as your name, email address and your state. By completing this process, you will get an OTP on your mobile number. Just enter the OTP and you will be in Unacademy family. So, let's crack it. Reflection. Laws of reflection. Imagine what will happen if light is allowed to strike over a smooth surface. To understand this, let us take a rubber ball and throw it on the ground. What will happen? The ball bounces off the ground. In the same way, light also bounces off the surface. The bouncing back of light after striking a surface is called reflection. For example, in the dark room, we cannot see things unless we switch on a bulb. Light from the bulb falls on the object and undergo reflection. Some part of reflected light enters in our eyes and we can see that object. The color of object that we see is actually the light reflected by the object. Rose appears red as it reflects red light towards us. Similarly, the wall appears blue as it reflects blue color towards us. Now suppose we keep burning a candle in front of a mirror. Here also, light from the object falls on the mirror surface and comes back to us. That means reflection takes place. Let us now discuss some of the key terms used in reflection. Reflection. Light when fall on object bounces back from it. The phenomena is called reflection. Beam of light. A highly focused light that goes in one direction is a beam of light. Ray of light. A fine beam of light is treated as ray of light. On a drawing board, if you fix white sheet and allow light to pass through the opening of the comb, leaving other openings closed, then it produces beam of light along the paper on the other side of the comb. It is a ray of light. Parallel beam or collimated light. When light rays are traveling parallel to each other, then the light is called parallel beam or collimated beam. Incident ray and reflected ray. If you place a strip of plane mirror in the path of ray of light, then you can observe the ray striking the surface of the plane mirror and then bending of ray from the plane mirror. The ray which strikes any surface is called the incident ray, and the ray that comes from the surface after reflection is called reflected ray. Normal. If you draw lines showing the mirror, the incident ray and the reflected ray, make a line perpendicular to the surface of mirror. At a point of intersection of incident and reflected ray, then the line is called the normal. Angle of incidence.
The angle made by incident ray with the normal is called angle of incidence. Angle of reflection. The angle made by reflected ray with the normal is called angle of reflection. With the help of these terms, now let's understand the laws of reflection. If you measure the angle of incidence and angle of reflections, you will find that these are equal. If you change the angle of incidence, in this case also, you will see angle of reflection is same as angle of incidence. This observation gives us the first law of reflection. It is stated as, the angle of incidence is always equal to the angle of reflection. If you reduce the incident angle, the reflected angle also changes. A condition reaches when incident angle is 0 degree, that is, incident ray is exactly aligned to the normal. In such case, reflected ray travels back over the normal. To understand the second law of reflection, let us first understand what is plane. A plane is basically a flat surface. It could be a surface of paper, surface of table, surface of a board, or even an imaginary flat surface. Here is a line. When we say a line is on a plane, that means every point of line is touching the plane. Here there is another line. Is it on the plane? No. Even if it is touching the plane at a point, still other points are out of the plane. And so, this line is not on the plane. The second law of reflection states that the incident ray, the reflected ray, and the normal at the point of incidence all lie on the same plane. This means there is one and only one plane on which all of these are present. Here we complete this topic. For more such interesting videos, visit LearnFatafat.com.